we welcome to the show Michelle Luscombe, who is in Hampton in Middlesex. Good morning, Michelle.
Hello, Gary. How are you?
I'm fine. And how are you?
I'm really nervous.
Oh, no, don't be. Please don't be. Nothing to worry about. Simple quiz.
It's exciting, though, at the same time.
It is. So what's this about you doing 50 challenges at 50?
Oh, my goodness. Yes, it seemed like a really good idea at the time. So I turned 50 in July last year.
Yeah.
And I wanted to raise money to help fund research into dementia. I lost my dad to Parkinson's and dementia. At the time, my mum was in a nursing home with Alzheimer's and vascular dementia. And so, yeah, I set up a Just Giving page and I sent the link to my friends and family and I said, set me a challenge in exchange for a donation. Let's see how much we can raise. And, it's been an incredible year and a little bit more because, unfortunately, I lost my mum in February.
I'm sorry.
Yes, it's been... Yeah, so I'm a little. I've given myself a little bit more time because I've now turned 51. But
but the challenges are still going. So how many of you? How many of you left to do?
Well, this is my 37th challenge.
To get on PopMaster, love that.
Yes.
Yeah.
My friend Fra Houseman set me the challenge to go on PopMaster. So this is my 37th. So yeah, 13 more to go after this.
What's been the most difficult one so far?
Oh, my word. Stand-up comedy, I think.
What?
I've done everything. I've done wild swimming, paddle boarding, horse riding, skydiving from 15,000 feet, you know, the works.
Wow.
But stand-up comedy was absolutely terrifying.
You're my hero, Michelle. You are my hero.
Thank you.
I tell you what, PopMaster is going to be the toughest challenge.
I know. My gosh, I'm literally shaking. But you know what? I've raised over £6,000 now.
Oh, so brilliant.
It's incredible. And I'm hoping my original target was 5K. So I'm hoping I can smash that and get to, you know, double that. Well, I've smashed it already, but hoping I can double that now.
That'd be fantastic.
So, yeah.
Real names or the young ones? Real names or the young ones?
Oh, my goodness. I'm going to have to go real names.
Okay. That's what you're going to get. I wish you the very best of luck.
Thank you.
On challenge number 37.
Yes.
Stand and Deliver was an early 80s number one for which group?
Adam and the Ants.
It was. Well done. 3 points. What?
Yes.
So excited with 3 points. Pay attention there. What type of symphony did The Verve sing about on their 1997 hit?
Bittersweet.
Bittersweet symphony as well. Yeah. Well done. 3 points. So, real names is what you've chosen.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to play you a 60s hit by Bobby Hatfield and Bill Medley. But by what name were the duo better known as?
Okay.
It's Bobby Hatfield and Bill Medley. What name were the duo better known as?
Absolutely no idea, I'm afraid.
It was the Righteous Brothers. Yes, huh? It was them. A song I played was You're My Soul and Inspiration. Question 4. In which year did these three songs all reach number one? Royals by Lord, Burn by Ellie Goulding, and Wrecking Ball by Miley Cyrus.
Oh, gosh. Is that 2007?
It was a little bit later than that. It was 2013.
Oh.
In 1983... New Edition reached number one with their first hit. What was it called? New Edition.
5, 4, 3. No, no idea.
No. Candy Girl. Bonus questions. Real names. You're about to hear a 1966 top 10 hit by Robin Smith. But by what other name was he better known? Right. Robin Smith, but by what other name was he better known?
I don't know.
The answer is Crispian St. Peter's. And the song I played was The Pied Piper. Question 7. The band Train made their chart debut in 2001 with which top 10 song?
Is that Drops of Jupiter?
Yes, it is Drops of Jupiter. Well done. Which Motown group had a top 3 single in 1976 called Love Machine? It was The Miracles.
Okay.
Your final bonus question, real names. Aren't you glad you chose real names?
No, not at all.
You're about to hear a number one hit from 1995 by Orville Burrell. Under what name did he release this record?
She called me Mr. Bombastic, tell me fantastic. Touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Romantic. Call me fantastic, touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Smooth.
Who is
Orville?
Shaggy. Shaggy, yay!
Shaggy.
See?
Oh, thank goodness.
Aren't you glad you chose that subject? 6 points, well done. Final question. The American vocal group that had hits in 1973 with Armed and Extremely Dangerous and Smarty Pants was called First What?
Sorry, what were the name of the songs again?
Armed and Extremely Dangerous and Smarty Pants. First What?
First girl.
First girl.
No idea.
It was first choice.
Oh, no idea.
But listen, you know what? Respectable score, 15 points.
Oh, thank you.
Well done. All right,
thank you.
We don't know whether it's enough. We're going to chat with Denny next, and then we'll come back to you, all right?
Okay, thank you.
Michelle.
Yes.
We have to say bye-bye.
We do. That was fantastic. Well done. There were some really tough questions in there.
Thank you, Michelle.
Michelle, do you want to say a few hi's?
I do. I really do. So, shall I go?
Yeah, go.
Okay, so thanks to Fra, who set me the challenge. She's currently on holiday in Croatia. Caroline's parents, Linda and Bob, I know they're listening. Louise, Beth, Kev, Matt, Sally and Rakesh, Danny, Sarah and Nick, my cousin Claire, the Vocal Phonics gang, Lucy and Rachel at Alzheimer's Research UK, the charity I'm working with, and everybody who has donated to my Just Giving page, including people who've donated while I've been on the show. Thank you so much.
Oh, that's lovely. That's really lovely. Michelle, good luck with the remaining challenges. Lovely talking to you today. All the best. Take care.
Can I have a signed photo, Gary?
Of course you can.
Thank you.
All right.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
Uh,